Hey guys, welcome back to another episode of Creatnprocess. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can apply double exposure effect in Photoshop. In this tutorial, I'll show you how you can apply those effects in very simple steps. There are three ways to create out this effect, and with each technique, you'll get different effects and style. And after that, I'm going to use those techniques and create out this amazing poster design in Photoshop. So let's begin with the designing process. With the first technique, I'm going to create this effect. So let's create out this effect. Let's open the image in Photoshop. So right click and open it in Photoshop. And here is our image. So the first thing we're going to do is to remove the background color. So background, we need to remove that. So to remove that, we'll go to select color range, and under color range, with the shift press, just click on the white region and it will add those white color. And with the alt pressed, you can add this black color over here. So after that, play around with the fuzziness slider. So if you increase the number, you can see it will brighten up the whole scene. And if you reduce it, it will make the darker region more darker. So what if I need is the darker region should be more darker and the background white color should be white. So by reducing the slider, I'm getting those effects. I'll just do the final click over here just to make sure that there is no black region along the white background, and I'll click OK. So this will do the selection, but still you can see there are some region which has not been selected properly. So, and over here, as you can see, some hair region has been left out. So to do that proper selection, I'm going to use under tool. So click on the selection tool, and this will activate this select and mask option. Just click on that, and after that, so command shift press with the I, you can inverse the selection. So after this, we'll use this second brush and just apply it along the edges where you want those details to be seen. So I'll just apply over here, just click and just apply it like a normal brush like this. Let's increase the brush size and just apply it like this over here at the eye region. I'll just do some here. So this way you're just making sure you are applying all the region where you feel like some selection has been missed out. So I'm just doing it like that. And once you have done everything like this, just click OK. But before that, you can increase the radius a little bit to increase the selection area, and then click OK. And here is our selection. Now after that, I'll just apply mask, and this will mask out the background region. Now as you can see, there are some region which is not seen properly. So with the alt press, just click on thumbnail, and this will bring out this black and white region. Now with the brush tool selected, just make sure all the inner regions are properly applied with white color. Now, as you can see, I have done all the inner region. The next step is to make sure all the outer regions are properly done. So to do that, I'm going to use this dodge tool. And with the dodge tool, as you can see, it will apply white color to the selected region. Over here, just apply it, and you can see it will make it full white color. And this means it's making proper selection over here. Now with your press, just click on the thumbnail of the mask, and you'll be able to see the image with the background removed. Now let's add a background color. So I'll just go over here and select solid color, and this will add a solid color. Let's apply white color and just place it at the background. Now let's do some adjustment with the composition. So I'll just use the crop tool and just crop out this region until her shoulder, and I'll just extend the surrounding area like this, and then click OK. So we got this composition. Let's bring in our background image, the image you want to apply for the exposure effect. So I'll just go to my folder and just bring in this city image over here and just drag and drop it to our file. Now I'll just place this on top of the image, and we'll do the masking to this. So we can create a duplicate of this mask and apply it to the background image. So with the alt press, just click and drag and drop it to the image, and your mask will be applied very simply like this. Now the next thing we're gonna do is to create another duplicate of this image, our subject image, and place it on top and change the blend mode to lighten, and this will add those details over the image. Now select the mask of the background image, and with the black color selected, just paint it over here and just applying over the hair. And I'm just applying it at this shoulder region as well. With the low opacity, I'm just blend it so that we can get some nice cool effect. And you can easily change the position of the background by just unlock it and then select the background and just move around very easily. Control T, and you can just move around here. Now let's add some effects. So we'll go over here, and the first thing we're gonna add is level. So let's increase the level of the image. Now I'll just add one more. That's a brightness and contrast, and we'll increase the contrast like this and the brightness a little bit like that, and I'll just map this to our background image. Now the next thing we're gonna do is we'll add one more level. This is for the overall design, and let's increase the contrast by using this central slider and a little bit of brightness like this, as you can see. And we can add one more adjustment layer, that's black and white. You can give some cool filters. So I think I'll use this one. This will give you that brightness over there, and I'll just reduce the fill value around 26, and this will add this nice cool effect. Now lastly, to give a little touch to the overall design, I'm gonna add a solid color on top and pick blue color, and we'll change the blend mode to multiply and reduce the fill value around 10 or 12, and this will give you the overall theme color to your composition. So this is our first technique. You can use multiple image, you can use any image. Now the next technique I'm going to show you is very simple, very easy, and that will give you a different look to your design. So this is our second effect we are going to create. So for that, let's open the image. So I'm going to go there again, and let's open it in Photoshop. So here's our image in Photoshop. Now the first thing we're gonna do is to remove the background color. So to do that, go to select color range, and here just click on the white region with the shift pressed, and with the alt press just click on the black region to make the selection. Use the fuzziness to increase the contrast and then click OK. So here's our selection, and now I'll just apply mask and command or control I to invert the selection like this. And now with the operator, just click on the thumbnail, bring out this seal out effect, and just make sure everything is painted white color. Now with the operator, just click on the thumbnail, and this will bring out our image. I have added a background white color. Now the next thing we're gonna do is to hide out a little bit of lower region. So I'm gonna give us some faded look over here. So with the mask layer selected, I'm gonna use the brush tool B, and with the black color selected, let's apply, and with the low opacity, just make it blend nicely like this. Now let's apply double exposure effect, and for this I'm going to use a mountain wallpaper image. You can use any image you want. Just go over there and select this image and drag and drop it to our main document, and here is our wallpaper image. I'll just scale up the size a little bit and place it around here. Now for this, we're going to change this image blend to screen, and you can directly see the changes over here. So I'll just place it like this. I'll try to scale up the size a little bit. Now we'll apply some black and white to each of the images. So select them and apply black and white like this to our image, and do the same for the other. So I'll just drag and drop it and apply it to it and clip it like this with the alt press. For this, we'll just go in there and change it to high contrast blue filter to give that dark feel, and we'll add a level effect. So I'll just go there and add a level and increase the contrast using the level like this, and just apply it to our image. Do the same for this and just clip it, and you can just reduce the contrast for our main character like that. And here is our image. You can anytime you can just play around with the position, and here we go. So this way I have created this image and this. So I used the level option. So as you can see, if I reduce it, you can see there are some faded effect. So I use the level to remove that until you see that clear only the tree seal outs. And after that, I use that level for that, and I added one more level to add some darkness. So over here, as you can see, we don't see anything like that over here. So I'll not be using level for that. And now lastly, let's add a gradient. Choose a gradient color you like and change the blend mode to soft light, and this will give you this nice cool effect. You can use this technique and create out any kind of design similar to this. In the third technique, we're gonna see how you can create these kind of effect. So the steps are very simple but slightly different, so let me show you. So first of all, let's open up an image. So let's open this image in Photoshop. Here's our image. Let's remove the background. So for that, we'll follow the same steps. Go to select color range and just make sure everything is selected. Click OK, then using the selection tool, select mask, command shift I to reverse the selection, and just paint it over the hair region and then click OK. And here is our image. And after that, I'll just apply mask. Go to the thumbnail and with the alt press, just click on it to activate the black and white. And here with the dodge tool selected, just paint all over the region. Here you can use the dodge tool to make it more softer. So I'll use the low opacity and just apply it like this. And then click on it and the selection is done. Now let's apply a background color. So I'll just bring a solid color, white, and place it at the back like this. And as you can see, our image is very dark. So let's add some brightness and contrast. So let's add a brightness and contrast, and I'll just be using the contrast and adding brightness. Make sure that it should not be burning at the edges. So just brighten up enough so that you can see the character. Now I'll just map it like this and just group this up. Now, and the next thing we're gonna do is to bring in our background image or any image you want to apply. So I'll just bring in this image of a tree and just hide this image, scale up the size. Let's remove the background color. So do the same process like this, click OK and apply mask. Command I to reverse the selection. This is a smart object, so you can scale up at any size and you'll get a proper detail. Now for this technique, we're going to place this image below our original image. So I'll just create a duplicate of this so that I can save a backup and convert this into smart object. And let's place this image below our character image. And let's change the angle a little bit. So for our image, we change the blend mode to lighten like this. And selecting this, increase the tree size. And we'll use this mask and apply it to our tree. So just drag and drop it and apply it. And here's our tree. Now we'll move around the tree, unlock the mask and just lock this layer and just move around with the tree. Get the position where you feel like it looks good and then enter. Now to add more details, what we can do is we can duplicate this layer and change the blend mode to normal and apply mask to it and fill it up with black color. And after that, with the brush tool, apply white color at the region where you want to show proper face details, and then our face is now visible. And over here a little bit of ear region and neck region, a little bit like that. And with the X, I'll just make sure where I don't want to show this. So once you have completed editing all this stuff, the next thing we're gonna do is to add the background theme color, so overall theme of the image. So I'll just go there and add a solid color, pick a blue color. I'll just pick this deep blue color and change the blend mode to exclusion and reduce the fill value around 20, and this will give you this nice cool effect to your image. So this is the third technique. In the first technique, we have seen how you can use blending option and create this effect. With the second technique, you can go with a different style and create these kinds of design. With the third technique, you can apply or mix any two image and create this effect. So now let's go and look at how you can create a poster design using these techniques. So I'm going to use the first technique. So for this, I have imported this image. So I just open this image again in Photoshop. Basically for the background, I have created a collage of images and used it as a background. So for that, here's our image, and I'll just create a new document and make the orientation vertical and click OK. So here's our document. Now I'll just bring in all the images I have. So drag and drop it to a Photoshop, enter, and here are all the images. I'll just select everything and change the blend mode to screen and change the background color to black. Let's choose a black color and alt backspace, and here's our image. Now let's do proper placement of these images, and if you see over here, I have placed some 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 images. So let's do that. So first image, I'll place it around here, scale on the size. And so overall, I have basically roughly adjusted all the images and placed it like this. Now let's select everything and group it up. Command Control G. Now let's bring in our image. So first of all, let's remove the background. Just use the color range. And okay. Use the brush tool, second one, and just draw along the hair. And as you can see, it will remove all the background and apply mask, darker tone like that, and with your press click on it, and here's the image. Now let's drag and drop this image to a file and place it over here, and let's do the adjustments. Now here's a background, here's the image. I'll bring the background to here and just apply the mask to the background as well. And for the background image, we need some solid color. Let's apply a white color and place it at the background. Now let's do some adjustment with the position of the image. So I just go into this group and we can just move around with the image. So command control T, scale down the size. So once you have done all the placement of your images properly, let's create a duplicate of this original image and place it on top like this, and change the blend mode to lighten. Now we'll erase out the region where you want to hide. Just use the brush tool with the black color selected and apply it over here, just to make sure that everything's is properly blended. And for the facial portion, as you can see, there are some details are missing. We can do that by going over here and just erase out this region. So brush, smaller size, engine with the full opacity, just apply it over here like this and here. So we'll just do some adjustments over here. I'll just use the brush tool and increase the size and apply some details along the ends and at the lower region as well, downward. And here you can see some patches. We can remove that by applying mask to the individual images. So let's see, here's our image. We can apply mask, and with a brush tool, let's draw it out, make it a little bit softer like this. So you can easily do that here also. If you see this line, we can apply mask and just draw it out nicely, giving a lighter tone to this. Now once you have done all these, we'll add some text. So I have used some text, so we'll just drag and drop the texts, and we just make it here. We'll just bring in all these texts. So finally, we have completed creating this poster graphic design using a double exposure effect, and I have used the first technique to create out this design. We can use the second and third technique to create another version of designs. The first technique was quite lengthy, but it gives you a cool effect. With the second technique, you will have to use the black and white image tone, and we'll be using labels to get the output we want. And with this third technique, we can blend two images properly and give a colorful effect. And I hope you enjoy this tutorial. Don't forget to check out the next tutorial coming up, and if you want more updates on designing, don't forget to like, share and subscribe this channel. Thank you.